Are you trying to control your word table so that it does not split across pages? Let me help. Hey, I'm Sharyn from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you save time, work smarter, and improve your Microsoft Office skills. Now, if you're using my 100 plus steps to proficient workbook to improve your Excel skills, I've popped the topic number this video relates to in the description box. If you haven't yet claimed a copy of this workbook, I've also added a link to where you can grab yourself a copy. Right, let's have a look at how we can prevent our table from splitting. So I'll just make my way down to the bottom of this page where we have a table. And here you can see that the second row of the table is splitting and continuing on page two. So I'm sure you'll agree that that's not a great look. So I'll step you through some options that will allow you to control where your table breaks and prevent these breaks from happening halfway through a row or maybe halfway through a table. Right, I'll show you probably the most recommended way to stop or prevent breaks. So what I'll do is I'll make my way up to this row and click on it. Now I'm just going to do a right click and come down to table properties. Now on here, on the row tab, you will see something that says allow row to break across pages. If I remove that check mark, Word will prevent the row that I'm on at the moment from breaking across to the new page. So I'll click onto OK and nothing changes. So this may be what you're experiencing. So I want you to come with me straight back to where we were before. So right click and go to table properties. And I want you to come with me to the table tab. Now, this is the option here that's the problem. Where you've got text wrapping around, change it to none. Now click onto OK and look. You'll see now that that entire row has been pushed onto the new page. Because of course we did change that option. I'll just go back again to table properties. On the row tab, we removed the check mark, allow row to break across pages, which then means no, I don't want this row to break halfway through and go onto the new page. So I'm hoping that's fixed your problem. Now, of course, what we've got here is we've now got this heading row left behind. So I want to take you just a step further and I want to show you how you can control that. So first of all, I'll just come up to here and I'm going to turn on my show hide characters. You'll find them on the home tab. So I'll just click those on. Now, I want to introduce you to a little marker that's out the side of this heading here and the caption over here. You can see there's a little black square. Hopefully you can see that. Now that is an indicator to say that there are paragraph settings on both of these paragraphs, and I'll just take you through. If I come on to table one here, now on the home tab you'll see that there's a paragraph area, and I'm just going to click onto the dialog box launcher for the paragraph settings. Just go and click onto that. Now normally this takes us into the indents and spacing tab, but come with me to the line and page breaks tab. Now in here you'll see something called keep with next. Now what that means is the caption will travel with the next paragraph of information. In this case, it'll actually be the table. If I come out of here, so I'm sure you know where I'm going with this, we can select row one and row two and any additional rows if you want to, go up to our paragraph dialog box launcher and come into line and page breaks. Click onto keep with next, click onto OK, and look at that. So you can see now that's been pulled onto the next page. And of course the captions come with it as well, which is always handy. We don't want the caption on one page and the table on another. And of course, if you're cross-referencing that as well with page numbering, that's not going to work very well. So if we come down a little bit further, you'll see we've got this problem again where we've got the row that's splitting. So again, I'll just take you straight back into those table properties. Remember, you just go to the row that you want to prevent the split in, right click, table properties, go to the row tab, remove the check mark, allow row to break across pages, click onto OK, and of course you'll see now that the entire row is pushed onto the next page. Of course you do have a bit of a gap here, but I'm sure that you could just play around with the spacing to lay it out and make it look a little better. One thing I would say here and would suggest is, of course, we've got our heading at the top of this page and it isn't at the top of this page. So what you can do is you can go to that header row, right click, table properties, repeat as header row at top of each page. Click that on, click onto OK, and now when you come down, you're going to see that at the top of the second page, which is so good. You can also get to that up here, so make sure you're in the table, go to the layout tab and you will see it up here. So you do need to be in that row, there it is there. Okay, so you can turn it on and turn it off from there as well if you want to. So I'm really hoping that those options that I've just shown you have fixed your problem and you're now able to control where your table breaks. Now, if this has been helpful, please let me know in the comments below. Please consider liking, following, subscribing, because I'm sharing new videos regularly. And if you know someone who would benefit from this help, please be sure to share this video with them. Hey, thanks for watching and have a fabulous day.